across the community Sunday. All the bells and whistles this morning, my friends, every single one of them, we're doing in this service. It's going to be fantastic. Welcome also because it is the second Sunday after Pentecost, and we are glad for the presence of the Holy Spirit here. Every Sunday, we gather by singing and then praying together to center our hearts and minds and then to receive the Word of God. So I want to thank you for sharing your prayer requests with me during the week and filling out the clipboards at the back of the room so that we can make our prayer together this morning. Let us be in an attitude of prayer. Lord God, it is a wonderful privilege to be able to come here on a Sunday morning. It means that you've given us so many things. You gave us our life and our health. God, you gave us faith. And you've given us a community. And so we thank you for all those things, for all those gifts that allow us to be right here this morning. For the air in our lungs, God. For the fellowship of the people around us. God, we take just a moment to center ourselves and root ourselves in this very present moment. And to thank you for all that you've given us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
The wrath of God. commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I stand. Here in the power of Christ I stand.
I hope you guys prepared an encore. That's tremendous. I'd like to invite the children to stand and watch heel toe, heel toe, heel toe up here. Is that a good one? Come on up. Come on. We're not even going to sit down. We've got work to do, friends. Sometimes at church we sit down and we're still and we're prayerful and we're quiet and we think deep thoughts. Right here, come with me. Eva. And sometimes at church, we're busy working. And today's the day that we're busy working, but first we need to talk about why. When people asked Jesus what the most important thing they should ever do is, he said it's one thing. It actually had two parts. He was kind of sneaky. But he said you need to love God with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and your strength. And then he said, second part, you need to love your neighbor as yourself. Can you say love your neighbor as yourself? That's right. And so at Aldersgate, we try to love our neighbors as ourselves, right? Especially our brothers and sisters, starting there. And then this group of people, and then the people in the community as well. So one of the ways that we love our neighbor as ourselves is, if you were really hungry right now, what would you want me to do? James? If you were starving right now, what would you like me to do? Give you food, that's right. And there's some people in our town who really have a hard time paying for all their bills, including groceries, and they're hungry. And so, as church, we try to feed them. So today, and for each Sunday in June, we are going to be doing food pantry collections specially from Aldersgate to the North Reading Food Pantry. And we've encouraged adults to remember to bring food and to have them, hopefully they have them in their seats. And we're going to take this red wagon and we're going to walk down the center aisle and everybody can pass their food and put it into the wagon, okay? And we're going to count it up. We're not going to count it up in here, but with Elena in the back, you can count it up and let me know at the end of the service how many pieces of food we collected, all right? Sounds like a plan? Oh, now there's going to be disputes over pulling the wagon. I'm going to ask for David to pull the wagon, but you guys will do the important work of putting the food in the wagon. Again, wait first, David, we're going to pray. Hold on. All right. God, we thank you that you told us what the most important things in life are, to love you and to love our neighbors as ourselves. Please help us to do a great job of loving our neighbors as ourselves and bless the people who will receive this food. Amen. And before you go, today Elena's going to be with you either playing in the nursery or outside. Also, if you want to come in and see the confirmation service, especially for those who have siblings being confirmed, you can do that as well. All right? Okay. Let's see how much food we get. try to increase, so level up for next week. We'll make sure to keep in touch with you on the church email about what food items are needed. Just while we're standing here, I want to draw your attention to a bulletin insert with two opportunities to make a difference at Aldersgate, two opportunities to serve. One is the upcoming final breakfast of the breakfast season this coming Saturday. And then in a few weeks, Bacon Bake Off, which we'll hear more about during announcements, I hope. All right, which is the kitchen celebration dinner at the end of the month. So please take a look at that. And if you can help out in any way, put it in the offering plate when it goes by later on. Our psalm this morning is Psalm 113. Let's read it together. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, you his servants. Praise the name of the Lord. Let the name of the Lord be praised both now and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to the place where it sets, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The Lord is exalted over all the nations, his glory above the heavens. Who is like the Lord our God, the one who sits enthroned on high, who stoops down to look on the heavens and the earth? He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the needy from the ash heap. He seats them with princes, with the princes of his people. He settles the childless woman in her home as a happy mother of children. Praise the Lord. And now please hear the scripture lesson from the book of Joshua.
This morning's thing, testament will be from Joshua 1, verses 1 through 9. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my son, my servant is dead. Now then, you and all these people, get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I'm about to give to them, to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon and from the great river, the Euphrates, to all the Hittite country, to the Mediterranean Sea, to in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Jerry. Please pray with me. God, what a gift this morning is. Help us to soak up all the different pieces of it, to not let it go by in a blur, but to observe this very special day for five of your sons. God, help us to meditate on this word and to meditate on all you give us. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I have a really brief word for the confirmants. Let me find them. Where they are. Okay. I was like, I'm missing a couple. All right, guys, I'm talking to you. So, when I was about your age, I started babysitting. I was in middle school, so maybe just slightly younger, not too much. Started babysitting, and I remember feeling really important and glad to A, be paid for doing something, but B, to spend time with the kids, and it was kind of neat to see the parents leave the house and be like, now I get to be the one who helps play with them, and it helps to get them a snack. It was neat. I was like, now I have more responsibility. I really like this. And I still remember the first time these two little kids, they were just three doors down from us, in suburban Chicago, three doors down, and I looked around and I saw a spider on the floor, and I thought, Mom, there's a spider. And I looked at it, and the kids hadn't seen it yet. Spiders play a big role in my early life. I feel like I tell stories about spiders a lot. This is true, though. And I thought, do I call my mom to get the spider? Because normally that'd be what I would do, right? I hate spiders. I'm terrified of them. And then I realized, actually, no. I'm here, the one in charge, the one with responsibility. It's my job to deal with that spider. So I took a bowl, a plastic bowl that they had, and turned it upside down on top of the spider and let their mom get it when she came home. That was about as strong and courageous as I was able to be. But it was that moment of being like, oh my goodness, who's in charge here? Look, find the person who's supposed to... Oh, wait. I guess that's me. I've taken a step forward in my own growing up, in my own responsibility, just right there in that moment. And I had to be a little bit strong and inventive to figure out how to handle it. In this section, the very beginning of the book of Joshua, Joshua is now taking the next step into leadership. Moses, had just got Moses, the one that they looked up to, the one that was telling them where to go and what to do and what God was saying, the authority figure, was gone. He had died. And then God says to Joshua, I'm still doing the same thing I was doing before Joshua. It's just now that he's not here. You're Johnny on the spot, my friend. You're the leader. And I mentioned Joshua at that moment where he looked around in certain times and was like, oh, right. That's me to make that decision. That's me to deal with that difficulty. That's me to figure out which way to go. He took a step forward in leadership and responsibility. That's what you guys are doing today. As you become now officially in the eyes of the church, adults in the eyes of the church, this is one of those steps you're going to take and will continue taking as you go through high school and hopefully into college or wherever you go after high school, as you step into the workforce. It's these steps of now stepping forward, being like, oh, look, I have more responsibility. Ah, who's in charge here? Oh, that's me. And I think that every single adult here in this room, no matter how old we are, is still experiencing moments like this. Adults, when you raise your hand and you're like, wait, who's in charge here? Oh, that's me. Okay? This never changes. You will continue to do this as you grow because you will look around and say, somebody used to be there in charge, and they're not there. And so now it's me. This is a lifelong process. You are taking one of those steps. And I want you to hear what God says to Joshua. I don't know if this should be concerning to us. Maybe it is. But three different times God says to Joshua, be strong and courageous. Then he says, be strong and very courageous. And then he says, just in that short reading, be strong and courageous. And if God is saying three times in such a short period of time, be strong and courageous, guess what? It's hard and it's scary. Because you're going to need to be strong and you're going to need to be courageous. Do you hear me? If he says, you know, take the load off, it's going to be nice. Just relax and figure out what drink you want to order. You know there's not a big deal. But if God is saying, be strong and courageous, guys, it's going to be hard. It's going to be scary sometimes. And all the adults, again, will raise their hands and say yes. All right, so I'm proud of you. I'm proud for the step that you're taking moving forward, accepting a little more responsibility. Be strong and courageous. Don't forget the God who loves you, because that's going to be the thing that is going to get you through on this. All right. Just think about that spider under that hole. I was mostly courageous. So today we are confirming four of our youth, all boys today. We've been a confirmation together for the last 2 years. Why did I say that? I have no idea. If I lose my mind, it's because I have one of the confirmants today. So I'm a mom and a pastor today. So you'll forgive any lapses in judgment or words or whatever. So we have five kids. One, however, is also being baptized today. So baptism and a confirmation, and that is Ashton. So just a very special morning. To start our confirmation service, I'm going to ask all the boys to come forward and just stand here behind the pulpit, all of you. They've each prepared a statement of faith that they're going to read to the church. And we will see pictures of them from their baptisms or other significant early moments in their life. While they're speaking, and when each boy is done. We're going to ask the boy's parents to come up and say something. Sam, if you want to bring that one on the floor, put that one to the floor. Then the parents can say something to their sons about what was stating to them. Yes.
The Tanners are actually going to speak up.
Exactly, yes. There's always exceptions in Catholics. We've got that one, Mama. Okay. In general, each family will come forward. All right, the liturgy on this thing was incredible. I actually just earned my doctorate in liturgics writing this service. So we are going in alphabetical order, Wesley.
What do you believe about God? I believe God is the power behind, above, and beyond all things. God is the one being above, beyond, and behind all. God is three persons in one, the Trinity, God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. These are expressions of God, but not three different beings. God is the source of all that there is. He created the world and everything that dwells within it. I believe that God remains in the universe after he created it, because without God, within the universe, there is no universe, no creation. There has never been anything before or without God, for God is all throughout the past, present, and future. God is set apart and perfect. He is holy. He is worthy of worship. God is personal and present with us. He is holy, but he is with us wherever we go. He remains active in our lives and in history. He gave Jesus Christ to show us his nature and how much he loves us. He does not abandon anyone. He is throughout our lives and we return to him when we die. I believe that the Holy Spirit is part of God with us. It empowers us to take a step or multiple in our journey with God. What do you believe about the church? I believe that the church exists so that we can learn about God and learn how to be closer to him by interpreting scriptures in the Bible. The church and scriptures from the Bible provide us with information for how to be close to God, but in the end, it is really the individual that has to put the knowledge of God to use in their lives to be with God. The church provides a safe place to learn, pray, and communicate ideas and beliefs with others. It allows us to continue our journey with God by learning of God's nature and how to be close to him. It also allows us to share a journey with our brothers and sisters in Christ. What does your confirmation mean to you? My confirmation means to me that I am now an adult in the church and I'm able to continue my journey throughout Christianity further into the future. I can do so and serve God by serving on church committees and continuing to help out as needed. My confirmation marks another point in the series of points in my journey with the Lord and the church that leads in the church that leads me to heaven. I can decide for myself that I am ready to follow Christ wherever he leads me in life.
Wesley, it's a special day for us, for you, for the church, to welcome you as a member. We love how involved you are in the various aspects of church. Even behind the scenes, you don't like to have the spotlight on you, but you still show up and you are a nice, solid kind of foundation that there is. It's exciting to hear you say what God means to you and to know that you're continuing on this path that we've shown you. And we're excited to see what God's going to do for you in the coming days and years of your life. And we know that we love you so much and that this church body really does love you. And we are here for you as you continue to grow and become more like Jesus every day.
Can't talk.
I believe that God created the earth, and he created it to be beautiful and perfect in different ways. This is the same for us. We are God's creations. But we make mistakes sometimes. We cannot just be perfect. But God always forgives us. God is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in one. Jesus is my Savior, and the one who died for our sins. I believe that God created us for a reason. I believe that God's ambiguous actions through us can create numerous embellishments on this earth. I believe that I have unearthed my purpose. I have stumbled upon the possible motive for my creation. I know that God has the power to fix all the problems, but from my understanding of God, he only does things through us, not through a direct approach. He allows for the opportunity to be evident, the opportunity for us to change things. I believe that God wants to help me change people. I accept this task. I believe that I can change the world by making people smile. I've always aspired to make people smile. For me to be able to change something bigger than myself, I need to rely on God. I need to be able to understand how people feel and react. And in my years in high school, it's been arduous for some points, but that's from a teenager's point of view. When things are rough or exhausting, I would turn to my mom's and my godmother, Roro. I see God in them. They help me get past those rigorous challenges, and they help me stay on track. They shed their knowledge of the world on me. My family lets God into their lives so they can teach me how to do the same. They embellish me and my siblings with God's spirit. I strive to be helpful because of them and God's love. When my mothers are not present at home or at school, I stand by my peers. I look toward the light. I always see God shining a light in the dark. It illuminates from within my friends. They light the flame, that which is my spirit. God shows me kindness through them, and he allows me to release my emotions in a fluid manner. I can see God in the people at church as well. God reminds me of who I am and what I'm supposed to do. I believe that the church is a place for worship and comfort. The church, to me, is a home of God. I feel closer to God when I'm surrounded by other church members and friends. They are the ones who make the church the church. Without God's people, it would not be a church. When I sing songs with the congregation, I feel closer to God and I feel joy. The church is a place where I can feel God's love flowing through the sanctuary. I feel it is my responsibility to help support the church by sharing my music and my other talents. I also need to spread the love of God. Being confirmed, in my understanding, is the coming of age where I'm allowed to aid the church and bring myself to acquire a stronger understanding of God. I'm being confirmed so that I can be an active member of the church and take on responsibilities whenever needed. I'm happy to be a part of this church, and I'm ecstatic to be a part of this family. Confirmation is the point in my life where I'm able to support others in the church and ultimately grow as one of God's children.
Sacrificed his only son, Jesus Christ, so that we may be forgiven of our sins. I believe that God has a plan for my life, and he is always there to help me along my path. There are some times in life when I wonder if God is listening to my prayers, and I feel that my doubts have strengthened my faith in God when he shows me the light of his love. I have experienced the greatness of God when he has blessed me with two amazing mothers, three wonderful siblings, that have helped me through my struggles and have been there for my accomplishments. I am eternally grateful for the miracles that God has allowed me to witness through the Holy Spirit. The church has been like a second home for me. When I come to church, I feel like I am among the people who are seeking to be part of something bigger than themselves and to sing praise to the one who has given us a second chance. I believe that the church is not just God's house, it is also God's disciples, which form the congregation. I can feel God's presence around me when I am outside and enjoying the beauty of the earth, but I especially feel his presence when I am at church. When I come to church, I tend to absorb sermons and take them to heart. I also come to church to indulge in the music and occasionally play music for God's people. My confirmation means to me that I have become a full contributing member of this church, and I openly welcome the Spirit of God into my life. When I stand in front of you today on Confirmation Sunday, I'm going to ask God to allow me to become a major part of my life and allow him to use me for his works. Being confirmed means that I have a greater purpose and responsibility serve the Christian community and my own church family.
I believe that God plays a part in all of our lives, whether we like it or not. I believe that God connects with us in our modern lives through the Holy Spirit. Since we all have the Holy Spirit in us after we are baptized, is the easiest way for God to reach us. However, God also reached out to us by showing his power through his Son, Jesus Christ. This was helpful because often people do not believe in what they cannot see. We can also reach out to God by praying. And though I've struggled in my faith a few times and been going with tough, I have still come back to God for help. I was mad and I didn't believe that God, that the God that we are told of could allow me to suffer so emotionally. However, I realized that I was just being impatient. I also realized that being mad would not solve anything. The Holy Spirit helped me come to terms that if things really got out of hand, God would save me. I believe that the church is an instrumentation of peace. All races, genders, and sexual orientations are welcome. There is no significant conflict in the church that we ever hear about. The church brings many different people together who otherwise might not have known each other. The church welcomes all talents and encourages the sharing of those talents. Peace is what God wanted when he created the world. I believe that church is the easiest way to get close to God. And in church, we can learn different perspectives on the Bible and learn what certain stories in the Bible actually mean. My confirmation means that I will be seen as an adult in the eyes of the church. I will officially be seen as a member of the church. I will have equal opportunities to help with projects and other things going on throughout the church. Just because confirmation is over does not mean that I can just become lazy with my beliefs and not do anything to reinforce my knowledge and beliefs of God. I must still continue my practices at home. And the easiest way, yet the hardest way to do this, is by keeping myself from sinning. I can do this by paying attention to my actions and noticing when I do sin. That way I can correct myself and ask for help from the Holy Spirit and God.
We have a clip from Ashton's godmother also. Do you want to go first, or do you want the clip to go first?
I think mine's go first.
Okay.
Oh, mine's. Can we have them come down? I feel like we're talking in the back of her. We're not.
Yeah, that's a good spot.
We wrote it down so we didn't leave on the mouth. First of all, I wanted to say, you guys were awesome. Thank you so much for sharing. It's really beautiful. What an amazing weekend this is for the Tanner family. Yesterday we celebrated the anniversary of Alex and Adam's adoption, and later this month we'll be celebrating the anniversary of Ashton's adoption. Our family has really been blessed by God in so many ways, and their confirmation is another day that we'll never forget and we will always be grateful for. Alex, Adam, and Ashton, we are so proud of you that you are being confirmed today and sharing your faith with your church family. We are proud of your commitment to God, your strong belief in the power of prayer, and your desire to always help other people because of your faith. There is nothing more important to us as parents than watching all of you grow in your faith. We see the love of God in each of your hearts. You are loving, kind, and compassionate guys.
Again, we love you guys so much. Each of you is so, so different from one another, and you guys have probably picked up on that as well. And each of you are different in your faith walk. Alex, your faith in God is strong, and your desire to pray anywhere and anytime makes us smile. Adam, the beautiful prayers that you say from your heart and your passionate belief in heaven bring us so much joy. And Ashton, your desire to believe in God, even though your life has been so challenging, is truly inspiring. We also greatly admire how active each of you are within the church. You're always willing to share your gifts with God, whether you're playing an instrument, singing the praise band, acting in the Christmas pageant, videotaping in the church, ushering. It's just wonderful. We're proud of the young men of faith that you have now become. Today you're being confirmed, and Ashton, baptized, and you'll receive a blessing to be filled with the Holy Spirit as you commit your life to Christ and become members of this church. You will share your faith today, and we know that the world will experience the love of God that your words and actions will bring them. Alex, Ashton, Adam, God bless you, and we love you.
My name is Becky, and I'm Ashton's godmother from San Diego. I'm sorry I'm not there with you today, Ashton, but definitely know that I'm thinking about you. Congratulations on your confirmation and your baptism. I'm really glad that God is a part of your life. All my love to you, bud. Have a great celebration.
Turned back to Aldersgate and I met with Rachel for Peter's baptism, seeing Wesley in the car seat, and just to see how they've changed and developed and what amazing young men they've turned into. And I'm very proud of you and of all of you and the hard work and the commitment you've done in meeting this goal.
Peter, we're very proud of you today and for all of your accomplishments. As you can tell, he's a comedian as well. Smooth out of shell. Today's celebration is especially important in your life and extra special for us as your parents. As you go older, as you grow, and as you experience life as a man, your faith in Jesus that you've confirmed today, your commitment to the church. For us, these things, we'll know that these will become basically your foundation as you go forward, right? And you'll have someone there for you when we're not there, and it means a lot to us as parents. We're really happy for you today, but we're also excited for that, right? And way to go. Okay.
going to have this given right over here.
Guys, don't ask for a word or a question.
All right, and so I'm going to ask you the questions of faith that you may have answered or were answered on your behalf when you were babies or for Ashton the first time that you will answer them. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your own sin? So say, I do. Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? So say, I do. And do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in his grace, and promise to serve him as your Lord, in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? If so, say, I do.
I do.
All right. Yes. According to the grace given to you, will you remain a faithful member of Christ's holy church and serve as Christ's representatives to the world? If so, say, I will.
I will.
And now for you. Do you, as Christ's body of the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include these persons now before you in your care?
With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround these persons with a community of love and forgiveness that they may grow in their trust of God and be found faithful in their service to others.
We will pray for them that they may be true disciples who walk in a way that leads to life. Let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Now we'll pray a prayer over the waters of baptism. Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across dark waters and brought forth life. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water, and after the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people enslaved in Egypt, you delivered them through the waters of the Jordan. Lord God, in every way that you've used water to show transition in our lives, we ask again today that you would use this water to show a transition into the life of your son, Ashton. Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and he who receives it, to wash away his sin and clothe him in righteousness throughout his life, that dying and being raised with Christ, he may share in his final victory. Okay. So, as each boy comes forward, their family, whoever in their family is invited to come forward to lay hands upon them as we look at. Wesley, may the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. May the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Ashton, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the Holy Spirit work within you that being born through water and the Spirit, you may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Now it is my joy to welcome our new brother in Christ, Ashton, please stand up. Through baptism, you are incorporated by the Holy Spirit into God's new creation and made to share in Christ's royal priesthood. We are all one in Christ Jesus. With joy and thanksgiving, we welcome you as a member of the family of Christ. And now, your confirmation, Ashton. Ashton again, may the Holy Spirit work within you who haven't been born through water and the Spirit. You may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Peter, the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
In the United Methodist Church celebration of Holy Communion is an open table. That means the invitation is from God to you. This church does not own this table. That means it's between you and God. Whether or not you come forward, we serve grape juice and gluten-free bread so that as many can participate as would like. I'll bless the elements, and then the ushers will help you know when to come from the center aisles. We'll kneel at the communion rail and receive the elements as we get them. Take them as you get them, and then wait for a dismissal to return to your pew by the side aisle. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with you, people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. At his baptism in the Jordan, your spirit descended upon him, and you declared yourself your beloved son. With your spirit upon him, he turned away to the temptations of sin. Your spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, proclaim release of the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce the time that the time had come when you would save your people. On the night in which he gave himself up, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is dead, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood and empowered by the gifts of the Spirit. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
The table is prepared. Please come. Thank you. eating and drinking with the saints. Arise and go into the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
awesome. Please stay standing for the announcements. We are moving along. Today, what you need to know, after this worship service ends, my mic is still not on. After this worship service ends, we will be having an initial meeting for the main mission trip. Maybe try this one. Right after the, maybe at noon, we'll start for the main mission trip, which is July 8th through 14th this year. There is a handout at the back of the room. If you want to learn how to sign up for online giving because you're going to be traveling a lot or away a lot this summer, I know that the people who write the budget would really appreciate it. There's a handout on how to do it, make it really easy so you don't have to worry that when you're away, you know, that the, I don't know, that your offering has arrived here. Please remember the two-minute rule. If there's someone you don't know in this room today, please go and say hi to them during the first 2 minutes after the service ends. A quick announcement about June 23rd, Saturday, a kitchen celebration potluck dinner. It is called the Bake On, Bake Off, Bacon Bake Off, or something like that. I didn't make that up. That's not me. The Bacon Bake Off, it's a potluck dinner. We want as many people to come and celebrate the new kitchen, which is just functional this month. So keep that in mind, June 23rd, Saturday. And Alex Tanner has an announcement.
So, Pastor Rachel, Mr. Sam, would you like to
wait?
So, if Pastor Rachel and Sam would like to lead me up front, please. So, this is a card from all of the confirmands, all five of us, for just helping us along the way. Along our journey and growing in faith and in God, leading up to this point, our confirmation. So, it's for both of you.
Thank you. May the God who has sent us the Holy Spirit through his Son, Jesus Christ, the God who has created us, be with us and confirm our faith until we meet again. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.